30 years old and I'm a third-year graduate student here at the University of Colorado Boulder in the Anthropology Department. My specialization is in archaeology. And this is my classroom. And these are my assistants. This is Lucy, the Australopithecine. Pedro, the Homo habilis. And my good man, Bob, the Homo erectus. And this is my good friend, Lisa. Today, we're going to teach you something about yourself. We have all undoubtedly at one time or another wondered what our purpose is here on Earth. How did we end up in this increasingly complex world that we live in? What events transpired that led each one of us to be born in a time and a place that is very much different from what our parents have experienced and their parents before them, going all the way back to the origins of our species? And what are our origins? This is a very complex question that requires the examination of multiple lines of evidence to answer. But to answer this question, we also have to ask another question. What does it mean to be human? What distinguishes us from all other life forms that we share this earth with? Is it our opposable thumbs with which we can manufacture and manipulate tools? Is it our large and complex brains which allows us to solve problems in new and unique ways? Is it the capacity for writing and language? These are all traits which are uniquely characteristic of humans. However, it is thought that the first major leap forward, which put our ancestors on a one-way track to where we are today, was the transition to bipedality. It is the habit of walking on two legs as a major mode of transportation, which is singularly human. But when did this trait evolve? To answer this question, we have to travel halfway around the world and 3.6 million years back in time to the Olduvai Gorge in present-day Tanzania. It is here, at the site of Laetoli, where we found some of the most insurmountable evidence of the passing of our ancestors. Footprints. The Olduvai Gorge is known as the cradle of mankind because of the large quantity of fossilized remains of human ancestors that have been found in this area. It is here where we see the first evidence of the manufacture of stone tools, known as Olduvai tools, and which date to around 2.5 million years ago. At 3.6 million years ago, a fortuitous sequence of events occurred, which allows us to glimpse a specific event in human history, which has deep implications for how, when, and where we began to become human. A volcano 20 kilometers north of here exploded, spewing tons of volcanic ash into the air. That ash slowly fell to the ground, covering the landscape with a layer of dust, similar to what we have seen in recent times following the eruption of Mount St. Helens in Washington State. Coincidentally, a rainstorm followed shortly thereafter, turning the volcanic ash into a thick, cement-like mud. This rainstorm would have also possibly filled a local watering hole, and animals would have come from all around to quench their thirst, leaving their tracks in the mud as they made their way across the landscape. We see here the tracks of baboons, rhinos, elephant, antelopes, and birds. But most interestingly, we see the tracks of what looks amazingly like the tracks that would have been left by a modern human walking barefoot in the snow. Why a human would walk barefoot in the snow, I'm not exactly sure. But that's another topic for another day. The development of footwear and the subsequent exploitation of third world laborers in sweatshops working for the profit of multinational corporations. But I digress. Shortly after these two humans strolled through this area in search of water, another volcanic explosion occurred, depositing another layer of ash over this layer, and thus preserving and protecting these tracks for 3.6 million years. That is, until they were discovered by Mary Leakey's team of scientists. Andrew Hill and a colleague were throwing elephant dung at each other. You may ask, why were they throwing elephant dung? Well, in East Africa, you can't have a snowball fight, so you have an elephant dung fight. As Hill dove out of the way of a flying elephant poop projectile, he stumbled upon what has become one of the greatest discoveries relating to the origins of our species. These tracks are the first clear and undeniable evidence that our ancestors stood upright and walked bipedally many millions of years ago. What we see here are two pairs of tracks, one larger and one smaller. It has been hypothesized that perhaps these footprints were left by a mother and child, or a man and woman. Who it was exactly that left these footprints, we will never know, but looking at the imprint of their feet, which shows a clearly defined arch as well as the big toe in line with the foot, tells us that these individuals had evolved a foot which was adapted for bipedal striding. These individuals and their ancestors before them had left a life climbing in the trees long before this to stand upright and walk on 2 feet. It is this moment in time in which we may sense a strong connection to our past that may be considered to be one of the most significant discoveries in the history of science.